Space, we're leaving Mother Earth to save the human race. Our star blazers, a cry for help, a desperate plight makes our star force reunite as we rush to meet our fate. The comet empire awaits. We must be strong and brave to stop its evil ways. If Zordar's plot should work, he'll destroy the universe. We'll fight the Comet Empire, battle through the raging fire, filled with the hope that Earth will survive. We'll keep peace alive with our star blazers.
Upon learning from Emperor Deslok of a possible second planet Earth, the Argo has finally reached a planet called Phantom and begun exploration. But after landing, the crew of the Argo have encountered many strange illusions on this promising but mysterious planet Phantom.
Captain Avatar!
The old skipper of the Argo! A monument!
Am I imagining?
A monument, then it disappeared. It was a monument to Captain Avatar.
What kind of planet is the planet Phantom?
What's that? You've been seeing illusions on planet Phantom, you say?
Yes, visions of people and things we've known. Can you explain it, Deslok?
It's puzzling to me.
We must make sure the planet is safe for mankind, and so if you have any further information or data, it might be helpful.
I'm sorry, but I don't. Rest assured, I would have given it to you when you left here, Commander Wildstar.
General Keeling?
Sire?
Dispatch a survey ship immediately to the planet Phantom and give me a detailed report of your findings.
At once, Emperor Deslok. I'll send Nesmeo, our top geologist.
Now enter into an extended warp. Destination, the planet Phantom.
Axis of coordinates in the interstellar space confirmed.
Coordinates G3, Y51, and B8.
Ready to warp, sir.
Warp.
Have you found anything, Sandor?
No, Skipper. I've run 100 tests so far, and each one confirms the planet's just like Earth.
But something's definitely the matter. Our instruments work perfectly, so what else can it be?
Ah, wait a minute. IQ-9.
IQ-9?
My chips are pulsing in confusion, having never encountered anything like it. Therefore, my logic components conclude danger may exist. Dangerous danger.
Sandor, you're right. Let's use IQ-9 to reanalyze.
Hello, this is the infirmary.
Dr. Sane, is IQ-9 there?
IQ-9? He was so angry he decided to take a nap.
Well, wake him up. We need him for some urgent work.
All right, but he'll get mad again. IQ-9, rise and shine. Up. Get up, IQ-9. Get your chips online.
What's the matter with IQ-9?
I have no idea. He refuses to do any analyzing, he said.
He refuses to work?
Well, he said his feelings are hurt because you don't believe his warnings of danger, so why go through it again?
His feelings were hurt? He's a robot, that's all.
Dr. Sane, tell him I want him.
IQ-9? Did you hear that? It's Commander Wildstar himself who needs you. Where's your loyalty, IQ-9? Stop sulking. Get up, you naughty robot.
How can I give warnings when nobody listens?
IQ-9.
Oh, Nova.
I'll listen. Won't you help us? Please?
Oh, golly. Anything for you, Chief Nova. I'm coming. Sorry.
What a character.
I hope he finds an answer.
We'll just have to wait for the test results. You men might as well rest till then.
Yes, sir.
It's been too long a time since I felt grass under my body.
There's nothing like soft green grass and a gentle breeze blowing, just like back on Earth. But those visions, what's causing them?
So that's the Phantom Planet, is it?
Jason, wake up.
Huh? What's the matter?
Look.
I don't see anything. There's nothing.
There was a girl. The most beautiful girl I've ever seen.
Come on, Flash. You must have been dreaming, that's all.
I wasn't.
Well, anyway, we'd better report this to the commander.
Okay.
Deslock. Major Nace Mayo wishes to communicate.
All right, put him on.
Yes, sire.
Hail, Emperor Deslock.
What have you to report, Nace Mayo?
Sire, the planet Phantom looks like our planet Galminia, the heart of the Galman Empire.
What? The planet Phantom looks like Galminia? You're positive of that?
I am. Have a look.
Right. Nace Mayo, inspect it immediately.
Yes, sire.
Major Nace Mayo, geologist of the Galman Empire. I've been sent by Emperor Deslock. He gave me orders to survey this planet Phantom.
How do you do? I am Commander Wildstar of the Argo.
May I ask you a question, Commander? Does this look like the planet Earth, or does it resemble the heart of the Galman Empire?
I beg your pardon?
What is your impression of it? Through your eyes, does it look like the Galman Empire or the planet Earth?
To my eyes, it looks like the planet Earth.
Does it really? It's very strange. Through my eyes, this planet looks exactly like the one I left, the heart of the Galman Empire.
Galmania?
Exactly.
But what you're saying is that this planet Phantom appears differently to whomever looks at it, depending upon his or her knowledge.
It can be whatever one wants.
Unbelievable.
It doesn't make sense to me. What kind of planet is it?
It's just like being under hypnotism.
Sandor in IQ-9.
Over here, Sandor. What happened? What did you find?
Nothing. But I vaguely came to a conclusion.
That's something, at least.
Who's that?
Oh, please forgive me. Major Nace Mayo of the Galman Empire. Executive Officer Sandor, also an expert on plant life.
IQ-9, give us your report.
Yes, sir. By consolidating all survey results, analyzing them, and considering all ramifications, I have come to the conclusion that this planet Phantom has a life of its own. It is alive.
A living planet?
Yes, a mammoth cosmic living body.
On what basis did you reach such a conclusion?
Once I investigated the mysterious phantoms and illusions, I found that the planet emits super psycho energy.
Super Psycho Energy?
Super Psycho Energy can manifest itself in a myriad of ways, but in this particular phenomenon, the energy works upon all human senses and surveying instruments to produce illusion.
But why is this done by the planet Phantom?
I have a theory. To protect itself from the natural forces of the universe and from enemies. Makes sense to me, at least.
Your theory does have a certain logic to it, Sandor. But it remains only a supposition. You have no material proof of it. And we must have proof. And so I plan to conduct some surveys of my own.
How do you plan to do it?
By penetrating the surface. I'm prepared to begin drilling immediately.
It could be risky.
You will be drilling into a living cosmic body. You could cause the planet Phantom a painful reaction.
I can't help it. I'm a scientist above all. I must base my own theories on my own personal research. Ready to start. Prepare to power the crust penetrator.
Drill now on maximum power.
Wait for my order. Release!
Forget it. We have to make a run for it.
What's that?
It's the skipper and the others.
Everybody, get into the Cosmo Hound! Jason and Flash.
I thought they were here.
I'll go back for them.
You can't. You'd be caught. We'll have to go back for them later. Come on. Jason,
are you sure? Isn't that the opposite direction from the base camp?
It's this way, I'm positive.
It's weird, isn't it?
I have a hunch it's leading us somewhere, but where?
Wrong way.
No, it's not.
Wait, Flash. Hey, wait.
Flash Contrail. Flash Contrail. Flash Contrail.
Living cosmic body?
Yes, sire.
Keeling?
Sire.
The planet Phantom has made me look like a fool. As soon as the Argo has made it safely out of Phantom's atmosphere, I want the planet destroyed. Obliterate it!
Yes, sire. I'll send the 10th Fleet under Admiral Gustav. Ready to warp to Phantom. Warp!
Emperor Deslok of the Galman Empire has ordered the destruction of the planet Phantom, a living cosmic body. But Jason and Flash are now trapped on the planet and perhaps lost in the maze of psychoenergy. And now, what will happen to the hopes of mankind? Only 95 days remain.
Alive with our star.